Welcome to New Directions for Women, a program of the Morris County, New Jersey chapter of the National Organization for Women. My name is Rebecca Lubetkin, and I and the entire production crew are members of this chapter of NOW. All of us, people in the studio, people in the control room, but I should say that we're very lucky today because we have two students who are assisting us. And they're not yet members of Morris County NOW, but I'm sure they're on their way. We're in our 190th show now after 16 years. And the show itself, this show is sponsored by the NewJerseyMaternityCare.com and its Worst to First campaign, working to reduce the number of unnecessary cesarean births in New Jersey from the highest in the nation, almost 40%, to the World Health Organization's standard of 10 to 15%. Today, we're delighted to continue our earlier discussion of the experiences of women in the criminal justice system. This time, we will focus on how these experiences affect incarcerated mothers and their children. To discuss these issues, we have three extraordinary guests, all attorneys, starting with my right, Sharon Katz, Madeleine Kurtz, and Martha Raimon. Right?
Yes.
Good pronunciation. So I'd like to introduce them. Martha is at my extreme right. She's an attorney with 18 years of experience working in the field of child welfare. She formerly directed the Family Law Unit at South Brooklyn Legal Services and for 7 years directed the Incarcerated Mothers Law Project at the Women's Prison Association. Currently a senior associate at the Center for the Study of Social Policy, Martha is part of the team responsible for monitoring the performance of child welfare systems. She's also helping to coordinate a group of birth parents that seek to influence child welfare policy and practice on the federal level. Welcome.
Thank you.
And next is Madeleine Kurtz. And Madeleine is currently Associate Director for Public Interest at Seton Hall Law School in Newark, New Jersey. Prior to this, she served as the family law consultant to the Incarcerated Mothers Law Project at Volunteers of Legal Service. And you're all still connected. Is that right?
In some ways.
In some ways. She has practiced law in the area of foster care and family law throughout her career, with a special interest in the intersection between the criminal justice and child welfare systems. She was a clinical professor at New York University Law School in an interdisciplinary program that brought together law and social work students to assist families of children in foster care. She began her career representing children with the Legal Aid Society of New York. Welcome.
Thank you.
And my contact is Sharon Katz, right next to me. Sharon is a partner in the firm of Davis, Polk & Wardwell, LLP, where she practices primarily in the areas of federal securities law and accountants and professional liability, and is co-chair of the firm's pro bono committee. More than 10 years ago, she began as a volunteer lawyer with the Incarcerated Mothers Law Project at Volunteers of Legal Service, through which she educates and counsels incarcerated women with respect to their rights and obligations concerning their children. She's also a graduate of the Columbia University School of Social Work and a member of the boards of a number of nonprofit organizations committed to fostering improved conditions within the prison system and aiding women with family reunification. And welcome, Sharon.
Thank you.
I'm delighted to have all three of you with us. I know that once you get started, you'll probably be interacting well with one another. So let me just ask you a question to kick off, and that is, could you tell us a little bit about the project itself?
Sure. I think as you heard, we are all connected through the Incarcerated Mothers Law Project, now sponsored by Volunteers of Legal Services.
And that's in New York City, or is that national?
Well, it's a New York City-based program, and it operates in a number of prison facilities in New York State and Rikers Island, which is a jail. We all have worked in that project. I've been there, as you indicated, for over 10 years, and Maddie and Martha have been supervisors in that project over various periods of time. Basically, we go into...
As volunteers, though, or as...
All as
all
well,
of you.
Your positions, I think, were paid positions
we were staff.
At the time.
We were staff.
They were staff, yeah. Mm-hmm. But what VOLS does is it recruits attorneys from various law firms throughout New York City, and those attorneys go into these prison facilities on a periodic basis, usually once a month. We meet with women in a, I guess it's sort of a clinic kind of setting. The women sign up to come down and talk to us.
As individuals? Or
as individuals. And well, we'll talk about that because there is a part of the program that involves education and may involve group meetings where we mm-hmm. do presentations to the women. But typically, the periodic work, the monthly work, is spent meeting with women individually. They come and they present problems, and they really can vary across the board. It can be questions about how did they find their children. It can be questions about a court date or a court proceeding that they have. It can be a question about how they get visitation with respect
they're
to
all
the
mothers,
children.
The ones
they're
you...
all mothers, mm-hmm. yes. That's the purpose of the program, mm-hmm. and that's the criteria for their being allowed to come and talk to us at the facility. And VOLS does have a certain amount of, very limited amount of wonderful staff that VOLS provides, so that those of us who, like myself, were not family lawyers by background and by training, but we go in there as volunteers, we are supervised and can turn to people like Maddie and like Martha for supervision and consultation. And so that's how the program operates.
And so as supervisors, then you have lawyers who, with whom you work, who are actually going into the prisons.
Right.
Are there a limited number of prisons that in New York State that have women?
Well, there are a limited number of prisons that have women, and this program operates at Taconic Correctional Facility and at
Bayview,
which is in Manhattan, and as I mentioned, at Rikers, which is a jail, New York City jail. Those are the only women's prisons that have this particular program, and there are other women's prisons in New York State. They just don't have this particular program.
Rikers Island, as everyone you know, knows, is a large, very, it's the largest jail, really, in the country, the largest population, and there's a small part of it, smallish part of it, that is only houses women. And so that's...
But at Rikers, they're only there for a limited period of time.
They could be there for up to a year.
Up to a year if they're
after sentence.
After they're sentenced. Yeah, but they could be awaiting sentencing for longer than or trial for longer than a year. But yes,
maybe even longer than their sentence.
Yes, that does happen, unfortunately, sometimes.
And are most of the women from New York City?
Probably, I would say most of the women are from New York City, but, you know, one of the things that I'm sure we'll talk about and I know you're interested in is the difficulties that women face in remaining in contact with their children. And very often there are women from upstate New York who are in the facilities close to New York City. There are women in the facilities close to New York City. I'm sorry, there are women from New York City
who are
in facilities very far away. From New York City.
Which you can't even deal with because you're dealing with the institutions
that
are
can't get up there.
Closer,
right.
Close to New York.
That's right.
Yeah. And I read that in the introduction that you head the pro bono committee of your law firm.
Right.
How did you get to do that? And how do you get them to support the time that it takes?
I have to say, my firm is very committed to pro bono activity, to public service, and it's something that the firm fosters and promotes. So I've never felt in any way that they were trying to limit.